Good morning to all my students. Take out your new Radiant Reader classroom book. Today I will start the third chapter. The name of the chapter is Letters from Assam 1. So Assam in the northeast of India has been called the tea garden of the world. So Assam is called the tea garden of the world. The writer of this letter was in charge of one of the many tea states in that district. So he is in charge of many tea states in the district, the writer. The letter was addressed to a boy in England. So he is writing the letter to a boy who is in England. Nahan Tea Estate, Assam, 1st December. Dear John, in your last letter, you asked me to describe the growing and making of tea. Now that is very big subject, but I shall try to tell you something about it. So he said that you have asked how the tea is grown and made. So it is a big subject, but I will tell you something only, little bit about it. Who is saying? He is in charge of a tea garden. He is saying, as you no doubt now, tea grows on bushes on a tea estate such as this one among the hills of Assam. There are thousands and thousands of tea bushes. So there are tea is growing in the hill of Assam, and there are lots of bushes, thousands of bushes. They are planted close together in long lines, and they look like shrubs that have been cut flat across the top, about 3 feet above the ground. So they are planted together, and they are planted 3 feet above the ground. Although all our plants are carefully raised from seed, it is interesting to remember that tea grows wild in Assam. Wild tea is quite a tall tree. So it is growing in Assam, and it is tall tree with much larger and coarser leaves than those of the plant which is grown in the state. So it is very large. Okay. Earlier in the morning, companies of Indian women and children, each carrying a basket, go off to the garden to pluck the leaf. So morning time, women and children with their basket come to the garden to pluck the leaf. They are cheerful, light-hearted crowd, chattering and singing as they work. So they are singing also when they are working. How brightly colored their clothes are too. Though many of the younger children wear only a string of beads, so their clothes is very colorful. The tea or the leaf, as we call it here, looks very, very like the young shoots on any bush that you can see at home. Only the youngest and most tender leaves are plucked. Youngest leaves are plucked, and the younger the leaf, the finer the tea. Two or three times a day, all the leaf that has been collected is weighted. Now after collecting, they are weighted, taken off to a factory in a bullock cart. So all these taken to a factory in a bullock cart, there to be made into tea as you know it. There they are making it as a tea as we know it. So that's all. Your homework will be, you will read this chapter till here. That's all.